Have you started to feel paralysed about your ideas? You're not trusting your plans, or you're feeling really doubtful about the projects that you're working on? Let's get you moving again. Whether you're working on an idea for a book or a current project in your business, it can be so paralyzing if we lose faith in ourselves. And often what happens next is we start to go on this investigative journey trying to figure out why we've frozen, or we start to give ourselves a really hard time because we're not making progress. And to be honest, most of this thinking simply makes matters worse. So what can we do instead? Firstly, it's to understand that if we have frozen, if we do feel paralyzed, there's a fear factor at play. You'll find loads of other videos on fear on this channel. If you're new here, that is a topic that I cover quite a lot. So do hit subscribe if you often find yourself in this predicament. So the fear factor at play, I want for you to understand that it's a little bit like what happens with a rabbit in headlights. The rabbit comes out into the road, so that's you with your initial idea, and suddenly this car comes along, the headlights are there, and the rabbit freezes. So something has caused that fear factor to take place. So the next thing to understand is, if you spend your time trying to figure out what has scared you, you're not going to be making progress. You're basically going to be dishing around in the past, trying to figure things out, but that's not going to get you anywhere. It's simply going to confirm why you're afraid and that it's logical to be afraid. So you're going to stay frozen. So what's really useful at this point is to have a mantra, which is take imperfect action. So let's go back to the rabbit in the headlights. If you imagine that rabbit staying frozen, thinking, now why am I frozen? Why am I so scared? The car just flattens the rabbit. Game over. Versus the rabbit in the headlights taking imperfect action, which would be to just leap free of the car. So whether it leaps into a muddy puddle, whether it leaps halfway up a tree, whether it leaps into a bank at the side of the road, wherever it leaps, at least it didn't get run over. And it's the same with our ideas and our projects. Often we can freeze because we're scared of what's going to happen next, and that stops us taking any action and we never make progress. Give yourself permission to make imperfect progress. And that way you're going to leap free of that state of being paralyzed, and simply that motion is going to generate new ideas and new perspectives and a newfound confidence that you can keep going no matter what. This idea of no matter what is such a core principle in the way that I work with writers and I work with creatives. It's the name of my Facebook community, Write No Matter What, where I'm sharing so many tips and techniques and support to help you get unfrozen and to help you make progress and achieve your creative dreams. So if you haven't found the community on Facebook, you'll find the link below and you will be able to come and join us. The third thing that I want to say about being paralyzed about your ideas is sometimes it's an indication to reach out for help. When we're afraid, when we get frozen, when we get stuck, sometimes it's a sign that we're just trying to do too much on our own. And it's okay to reach out for help. So feel free to reach out for help on this channel. You're very welcome to pop something in the comments below. Are you frozen? Do you need some feedback on a current idea? Do you need some validation on a project that you're working on? Alternatively, as I said, come find me in the Facebook community. I would be happy to help you on your journey. So wishing you all the best with your ideas and your plans and your projects. Remember, taking that imperfect action is going to get you out of those headlights, get you unstuck, and get you moving once more. I'll see you next Monday on the sofa. Take care until then.